Welcome, it's Michael Murray with Benzinga, joined here today by Michael Garreau, the chairman of the board and founding president and CEO of Starpax Biopharma. Michael, start us off by telling us what the major challenge was that you faced in cancer treatment.
In cancer treatment, there are many challenges. One of them is side effect, especially from systemic treatments. I mean, injecting drugs in the blood system or through oral administration. In this case, many studies have demonstrated that only 1% of the dose injected reaches the tumor, while 99% of the inject toxic drug circulates in the whole patient body, creating unwanted side effects. Another major challenge in treating cancer is reaching cancer cells throughout the whole volume of a tumor. Multiple studies around the globe have demonstrated that 90% of the volume of a tumor receive little or no drug at all. Think about it. 90% of the volume of a tumor receive little or no drug at all. The reason is simple. When a tumor grows, blood and lymphatic vessels are deteriorating and become malfunctioning, chaotic, and often collapse. Then the diffusion of the drug or immune cells in the tumor is really limited. In a hypoxic area of the tumor, where oxygen is almost non-existent, there are no vessels to ensure the diffusion. Think of an Amazon delivery truck arriving in a city after an earthquake of magnitude 10. Roads and bridges are inaccessible, impossible to make an efficient delivery. That means drug or immune cells barely travel throughout the tumor volume because they need blood vessels to be diffused in the tumor. This is a real major problem of resistance to treatment that systemic chemotherapy or even immunotherapy haven't solved for over a century. That's what Starpax has been conceived for, solving this huge problem by diffusing drug throughout the whole volume of the tumor while eliminating side effects at the same time.
Understood. And what differentiates Starpax technology from other cancer treatments on the market as you now come into this space, especially with your challenges in the past?
Starpax is not an ordinary pharma or even a biotech. Our company is formed of four different scientific departments: microbiology, biochemistry, electromagnetism engineering, and artificial intelligence. And it took all these disciplines to create a unique treatment platform to treat cancer. We have developed living magnetodrones sensitive to very special magnetic field. These magnetodrones transport an anti-cancer molecule attached to their surface that is used in FDA-approved treatment. The magnetodrones are living microorganisms that are injected directly into the tumor and don't circulate in the blood system. They swim between the cells of the tumor tissues. We have also conceived a medical device called the PolarTrak, which generate unique magnetic field. These magnetic fields create a magnetic sphere around the tumor, conceived to trap the magnetodrone inside the tumor, thus limiting side effect. At the same time, the PolarTrak forced the magnetodrone to spread throughout the volume of the tumor while they release the drug on their path. In summary, we inject magnetodrones directly into the tumor and they bring up to 50 times more drug than systemic chemotherapy. The magnetodrones swim and don't need blood vessels to travel in the tumor, while drugs don't swim and need blood vessels to be transported. The PolarTrak is conceived to keep the magnetodrone trapped inside the tumor, limiting them to spread in the patient's body, while systemic treatment spread 99% of their toxic drug throughout the whole patient's body. And finally, the PolarTrak controls the trajectory of the magnetodrone in order to spread throughout the tumor volume, including hypoxic area, while systemic drugs can only be diffused by blood vessels, thus barely spreading in 10% of the tumor volume without even being able to diffuse in hypoxic area where stem cells are located.
Absolutely. And what's the timeline for your clinical trial on humans?
Our primary objective is to initiate clinical trial on humans as early as possible. So we aim for June 2024. Our Magnetodrone's GMP manufacturing plant is completed and the PolarTrak is already installed at the hospital. Phase one of our trials is expected to last 6 months. We know that usual clinical trials take longer than that, because they target only one rare cancer and patients are also rare. For Starpax, it will be a little bit quicker than usual because we will treat 6 types of cancer at the same time with the same drug that has been already used for these 6 cancer indications, thus having more candidates. We will target patients with unmet medical needs in the following organs: pancreas, breast, prostate, colorectum, head and neck, and vulva. We plan to conduct phase two of our trial with each cancer type in succession. So we expect that phase two will last 3 months for each cancer. Our trials protocol is designed with the objective of filing results to the FDA for a commercial approval following completion of phase two trial for each cancer type. In order to meet our expected timeline, we plan to cooperate with various hospitals in the US and Canada when recruiting patients.
Got it. Now, Michael, you're aiming for FDA approval for 6 unmet medical need indications. What impact do you think Starpax's success is going to have on the eradication of common cancer specifically?
As you said, our clinical trial will target 6 types of cancer, and a magnetodrone will transport an anti-cancer molecule that has been used in humans for over 20 years. Thus, toxicity level and maximum dose are well documented, and we don't intend to exceed these limits. According to our protocol, we will inject less than 20% of the dose of the drug that is usually injected in traditional systemic treatment. Furthermore, as we inject directly into the tumor, not in the blood system, no meaningful side effects were observed in our preclinical studies. Indeed, each animal was analyzed by an independent institutional laboratory, which concluded that no inflammation nor pathological change were observed in the animal's liver, kidney, heart tissue, and other organs. This anti-cancer molecule that we will use in our trial in humans is already used to treat cancer as a first-line medicine. Therefore, following commercial approval for unmet medical needs, we plan to proceed with additional clinical trial with the objective of being approved as neoadjuvant for many types of cancer, because our treatment has the potential to become the lowest toxic cancer treatment. Then we could consider the Starpax treatment platform being an advantage to treat weak and very old patients and probably young children at all levels of cancer. Getting an FDA approval for our first clinical trial is not the ultimate goal, but just a starting point. They are cancer disease, but our pipeline also comprises non-cancer disease. Our technology extends possibility to being multi-drug and multi-disease and even to diagnostic solution. The Starpax technology is a sophisticated solution platform with unlimited application.
Fantastic. Michael Guerreau, Chairman of the Board, Founding President, and CEO of Starpax Biopharma. It's been an absolute pleasure hearing your story and talking with you today. Thank you so much for joining us.